How the hell did we get so many pumpkins?
To make so much money, that's why.
But we have to get these pumpkins into the still site. I know it's an arduous task, but we're moonshiners. That's what moonshiners do.
Man, this is a whole lot of pumpkins.
I know.
We're gonna be back here cutting all day.
Yep. How about we get one of them empty mash barrels and we start it off?
Since Craig and I came to Mac Valley, our moonshine's been selling like hotcakes. I mean, we even got a seasonal order for a pumpkin spice moonshine. Only one problem, that really ticked off Mike Cockrell.
Look, they done tore the damn steel up.
That's our elbow right here. I think they took it.
Look, what else them got? That's our elbow.
We're gonna get the hell out of here.
So we're not gonna take our steel piece so we can at least start making some?
No, this is their stash spot. We're gonna get them later.
We don't have a functioning steel. Mike and Jerry stole our thump elbow, but that's not gonna stop us.
Fire in the hole.
We're gonna get this pumpkin spice mashed in, and while it's working off, we're gonna solve our elbow problem. All right, we're gonna just do some quick measurements here, man. We need 1 4x2 connector here. So that's gonna take this 4-inch and turn it into a 2-inch where we could put a 2-inch pipe out of there. I'm real pissed about the fact that we even have to get into building a new elbow for this arm. We know that Mike and Jerry took that thing. They think that we're gonna be stopped, but I can do anything. We're gonna build this arm, and as soon as this mash work off, we're gonna get right back in production. Come on, we might as well get to work. Mike and Jerry think they knocked us out, but we're right back up and ready to keep fighting.
Craig, I think our new elbow look good, man. We can start bucketing some mash over, start getting everything ready.
We got 150 gallons of mash.
Using market digger steel,
we should come out with 15 gallons of a real good pumpkin spice moonshine.
All right, last one.
Look at that. Look how pretty.
Wow.
This is something that everybody could enjoy, whether it's Thanksgiving, Christmas, Easter, whenever, and for whatever.
How many jars you got there?
This would be number 8 right here.
That's 2 gallons of some damn good liquor. Liquor nobody else got around here. Hi,
Jeff. Oh, what the hell? Man, what the hell happened?
What the hell happened, man? Oh.
God damn, that arm blew off of there, man. Cut the gas, cut the gas.
Shut the fire.
It blew the damn elbow. Look at all the damn alcohol we're losing.
What happened?
It must be too much pressure. Pressure built up so strong. Son of a...
Now what we gonna do about the rest of this run?
We can't do nothing but shut it down, man. It's too dangerous to keep running that thing. Look, that thing blew way over here.
Oh, that's one piece of it. Damn, it's hot, watch it.
Man, look at that.
Oh my goodness.
Look how much force that thing hit with, man. That is stupid, dumb, crazy.
It bent copper piping.
Look at that, that would've tore somebody's head off, man. We got all this effort, all this time. We got all that mash sitting up in there. We're gonna have to get an elbow. That mash ain't gonna be no more good in a little while. It's a big setback right here, man. We got a customer waiting on this right here. We ain't got but 2 gallons to give to him. We're gonna have to get our elbow back.
Damn it, let's go get it.
Yeah, we'll get her and get this old stashed up in your barn.
One more load down.
Me and Jerry, we got another damn run alcohol runoff. We gotta go stash 10 more gallons in our stash house. Bringing liquor to the stash house, it's like putting money in the bank.
It is a maze for sure.
Mm-hmm.
Amazing we can get back here.
That's right. Something don't look right, Jerry.
It's not quite exactly like we left it. I had it tucked in underneath that
you did.
Piece of machinery right there.
You did, didn't you?
Yeah, all the liquor's here.
It's still alcohol. Maybe I'm letting my imagination run wild. All the liquor's here. Everything is still stacked right here just the way me and Jerry left it. But I don't like the way this looks. The elbow's still here.
Was it standing up in the box like that?
No, I thought we had it laying flat down.
That's what I was thinking, it was just laying down flat in that box.
You don't reckon somebody's been just snooping around, do you?
I don't know, that's kind of weird.
You know, me and Jerry, we took Richard and Craig's thump elbow to set them back, and I know I laid it flat in this box. It ain't like somebody's tore up anything. I think we just need to go ahead and just check the damn camera. This camera that we've got, it's remote activated. Anything that crosses its path, it's going to kick on and record for 2 minutes.
I'm going to fast through some of this stuff here.
Yeah.
What is that? That's somebody walking in right there.
That's damn Richard and Craig, man.
What the hell?
They're looking through our. There goes picking that damn elbow up.
So they've been here. Why is our stuff still here?
They may not want us to know.
That they've been here?
That they've been here. I don't give a damn why they didn't take nothing. Well, by God, they have missed their damn chances. All I can tell them, because they ain't getting this damn liquor. We got two damn options. Get it all out of here, or get up in the sloth and watch them till they come back.
You and Mike, y'all not gonna jam together. How about if I call Jerry? He has the cooler head, and I can get him to convince Mike maybe to meet up with us.
I got Jerry's number. Mike's a little hothead, and I get hot-headed too, so I think we're gonna let Craig make that phone call.
Hello?
Hey, Jerry.
Yeah?
Hey, this is Craig.
Well, well, look who finally decided to give us a call. What you got on your mind?
I'm calling you because I know you have the cooler head. Maybe you can convince Mike to meet up with me and Richard and you, and we can talk about this elbow that you have.
Well, you know, Craig, it's a little hard on us. We're just kind of having a little headbutting issue going on with our customers. And, you know, we're not really too happy about things right now.
Yeah, I know. That's why I would like to meet, and we can talk this out.
All right. We're down for it. All right, about the old Johnson Bridge inside that cow pasture.
We'll meet with you guys in a few.
All right.
Bye.
I'm not playing with them no more. We're going to get our elbow today. All right, that's the bridge right there.
We're just gonna be real cordial-like, right?
You know, Mike and Jerry, they have the upper hand right now. So we're gonna have to be real smart about this. Come and meet with these clowns and see what they talk about.
Let's just see what they got to say.
What's up, guys? How y'all doing?
Better than you, obviously. What you want?
I know y'all got our elbow, man. Could have took it and took all your liquor.
Should have took it while you had the damn chance. It's too late to get either one of them.
You're causing a lot of headache this season.
What did we tell you guys the very first damn time we met up with you? We said, welcome to the mountains, but don't step on our toes.
Well, you know, I was
going around selling to our customers, stealing our recipes. That's as low as you can go.
I ain't got no problem with taking a half-assed recipe and making it whole.
Okay. We've been actually really damn nice. We want your asses out of here.
Well, we ain't trying to go nowhere.
We've invested our time for years here, and we've got a lot of liquor stashed back because we can't sell it.
It's not our fault that you guys alcohol is not selling.
When it comes down to our livelihood, we'll do whatever necessary to get your ass finished.
You know what you need? You need to learn what a good ass whipping feels like.
I'm your huckleberry. Boy, bring it. Damn, I love war.
You're starting one, man. And
I ain't started. You got it started. We just gonna
finish
it for
you. I can't bury the hatchet, man. You want to shake my damn hand?
I don't never bury the damn hatchet. I keep it nice and shiny.
Man, I just need that elbow back.
That's what you get trying to take over somebody else's territory and their livelihood.
That is not my steel. It's Mark and Digger's steel.
I get it. What fascinates me is this 18-inch piece of copper right here is holding the moonshiner up.
Yeah. Damn.
It did. It did. The elbow back. I can't believe them clowns gave that back.
They gave it back. They actually gave it back. We never letting this go again. What made them give this back?
Mike knows. He can't play with Mark and Digger like that. Well, once I told Mike and Jerry that was Mark and Digger's stump elbow that they stole, I can tell Mike and Jerry are scared to death of Mark and Digger.